So hello everyone, and welcome to the Scientix webinar entitled Professional Development of STEM Teachers, A Teacher's Perspective. My name is Marina Jimenez, and I will moderate this session. First of all, I would like to remind everyone, I am actually hearing myself, there's some echo, so please everyone turn down the volume, turn down the sound and the cameras, except for from the presenters. So with us today, we have Panagiota Argiri. She was a mathematician at the Model High Evangelica of Smyrna, sorry for my pronunciation, in Greece. She's a Scientix ambassador, and she has taken part of numerous workshops and conferences, gaining experience and knowledge on how Scientix supports STEM teachers. She has also been an ambassador for the Inspiring Science Project and the GoLab Project, organizing seminars and training courses for the Palatine Greek schools, and has a position as a tutor in STEM lessons within the Educational Department of Aspeta. The other presenter of today is Nikolaos Nerantzis, who works as a physicist on the secondary special education for 6th junior high school and the 24th high school of Thessaloniki. Since 2006, Nikolaos has been supporting and encouraging scientific education within students while inspiring and engaging many other colleagues in innovative teaching and in the promotion of science education both in the national and the European context. So our speakers will talk about professional development in STEM education with the goal of supporting primary and secondary teachers no matter their individual level in STEM. My colleague Enrique with the Scientix account will be helping you with any technical problems you may encounter, so please write to him privately if it's any difficulties in attending this session. At the end of the session, we will have 15 minutes in which you will be able to address questions to our experts through the chat, but you can also still post them during the whole webinar, where we will be recording them. So this is all for me. I will leave the floor to our speakers, and I hope you enjoy.
Dear all, good evening. First of all, I would like to thank European Schoolnet and Scientix for this opportunity. Please, as Marina said, close all of you your microphone, because we are listening to you. Turn off all your microphone, please. I repeat again that I would like to thank European Schoolnet and Scientix for this opportunity. Professional development for a teacher of science is a continuous, lifelong process, so at least we are looking for opportunities. An opportunity is this webinar, so we thank you, all of you, for your participation. The main topic of this webinar is ideas to support primary and secondary teachers on ongoing professional development. It doesn't matter in what level of STEM experience you are. We will present a plethora of initiatives, ideas and possibilities on ongoing and development. Professional development for STEM teachers should be analogous to professional development for other professionals. Becoming an effective science teacher is a continuous process that stretches from prevalent experience in undergrad years to the end of a professional career. So, Nikolaos, why?
So, why professional development? There are more than 5 million teachers in Europe. As teachers, we have to follow a curriculum. We must produce and deliver didactical material and procedures. And of course, we have to inspire our students. At the same time, the demands on our profession in a continuously changing and complex environment are uprising, meaning that it's essential for us teachers to get support on developing our knowledge and skills. Moreover, we are not perfect, so we need to be aware, and when we are aware of a specific weakness in our teaching, we need to be motivated in order to make all the change necessary in the right context, not only to be improved, but in order to understand the specific best practice and tools that help us.
Paragiota. Well, of course, we are starting for our host, European Schoolnet. European Schoolnet is a network of 30 European ministries of education based in Brussels. It Main objective is to promote of innovation in education, implementing and supporting a large number of projects in collaboration with ministries of education, schools, teachers, researchers, and industry partners. One of the key elements is to achieve this goal is to support of ICTs in education-related topics, using ICTs as a force for improving learning and teaching. 100 schools in Europe are engaging with various projects, as you can see in your slide, trying new learning activities and technologies in classroom, exploring the use of new methods for STEM teaching, and giving the feedback necessary in order to achieve optimal training packages.
Well, now, what else? In the European Schoolnet, someone can find, someone can find material, resources, guidelines, comments, experiences, best practices and views on educational trends, and also international country reports and major events on innovation of education. Let us make 3 points here. The guidelines are based on recent reports, surveys or school pilots as an outcome within projects, Ministry of Education and industry partners. The country report initiatives is one of the major activities undertaken by the European Schoolnet in order to gather, analyze and foster the active information exchange on ICTs in education across Europe. Moreover, from its start in 1997, European Schoolnet supports and actively involved in the open educational resources movement in Europe.
Well, as I referred before, European Schoolnet is one of the main players in Europe and beyond in learning resource exchange. In collaboration with its network of schools and teachers, European Schoolnet has also contributed to the development, teaching and validation of new resources, integrating the efficient use of ICTs on innovative pedagogies and teacher skills. To inspire teachers and headmasters, European Schoolnet support the outcomes across its project and focus area, for example, how to integrate social media in learning and education is an example of my digital handbook that you can find. How to make the most of your interactive whiteboard and the development practical guidance for one-to-one computing initiatives. Well, what other? European Schoolnet Academy now.
Yes, combining all the above, the European School Academy is an online platform where you can learn about innovation in the school classroom. The MOOCs offered in this platform are completely free of charge, of course, and they are offering an introduction on key concepts and key ideas, providing also the opportunity to discuss these ideas and share your experiences with your peers.
Well, I would like to notice that during our speech, we share more links with participants to the chat. Just I sent 4 links, I think also you too. And now we will present some examples of latest courses that there are in European Schoolnet Academy. The current course is Administering School ICT and Structure, Developing Your Knowledge and Skills, that brings ICT together administration to hear about current practices and new developments. The course, Collaborate Teaching and Learning, is a previous course and help you to better understand what is collaborating learning and how can you carry it out effectively in your classroom. What tools can you use to assess collaborating learning? One of the courses that me and Nikolaos, we participate and we gain many experience for our science classroom is teaching with space and astronomy in your classroom, and had as objective the training to successfully teach speak space related topics. It aimed to educate teachers how to introduce and attract more and more young people to careers in space. via inquired based science education teaching practice, detecting use of ICT tools, managing diversity and obtaining. In all past courses, you can access their material and get knowledge for your professional development, but not take a certification. Other past courses are Gaming School 3D Round, Introducing Computing in Your Classroom, Industrial Technologies Exchange Teaching. Each course runs usually for 6 weeks with one module opening each week. Depends on subject in each module, you are training in different topics. You start discussion to forum with other participants. You exchange your views while participants reply questions of the week. The estimated workload is 3 hours a week, but the expected value for you is more and more important than the hours that you spend.
Teacher Academy now. Teacher Academy is a European school service that supports teachers to access relevant training opportunities by providing a platform for search, for participating and for evaluating training courses available on-site and online across Europe. The Teachers Academy offers a central course catalog with information of free online courses for teachers, teachers educators, and not teaching staff involved in school education, from pre-primary to upper secondary. In addition, teachers can find a selection of teaching materials developed by E2E teachers, EU institutes, and EU-funded projects on the Teacher Academy. As we noted, there are more than 5 million teachers in the Europe. The knowledge, the skills, the attitude of each of them are of a great importance, and the quality of the teaching, of our teaching, has a direct effect upon our learners' outcomes. We can receive professional development of highest quality starting from initial teacher education, through early career support for novice teachers, and followed by opportunities for continuing professional development throughout our careers.
You could access to resources, publication materials, and toolkits for teachers and school readers to stay informed and exchange their practice. You could browse content by theme. As example, our basic skills, citizenship, early childhood education and care, languages learning, tackling early school living, teachers and teaching. A basic resource included the European Toolkit for Teachers. Then you can find several interesting areas as general information, school governments, teachers, support to learners, parental involvement, stakeholders involvement. These 5 areas have been divided in a number of sub-areas which contain examples of specific school level actions. And each sub-area provides a short explanation as to why this dimension is important for learning success and prevention of early school living, with evidence from receipts, example of interventions at the school level, and links to further reading. A number of resources ranging from receipt studies, project reports, to concentrate example of good practices describing how a method was successfully implemented with content details were available. And now we pass to Future Classroom Lab. Nicolas.
At the forefront, this is yours.
Yes, because I was attending to an event of Future Classroom Lab previous September, and I gained many, many experience of this. But first of all, I would like to say that at the forefront, at the forefront of European Schoolnet's continuing professional development opportunities for teachers is the Future Classroom. Future Classroom offers a full equipment, teaching and learning space development in association with leading education technology providers. And as I say, I have the opportunity to participate to an event on September. In this course, the participants are invited to register in a course on innovative practices for enhancing STEM teaching. The six-day course introduces participants to resources and ideas that help us develop more enhancing science lessons and increase our students' interest in STEM subjects and careers. Many of these experiences I bring to my science classroom in my school. The course offers a combination of hands-on workshops and on active exploration of resources, including visit to virtual research center, an innovative tool for my classroom and your classroom, of course.
Except of workshops, seminars and courses are organized for teachers, experts, policy makers and ICT suppliers on how existing and emerging technologies can have a transformative effect on teaching and learning process. Moreover, plenty of distance opportunities such as webinars and online training to reach out to greater numbers of teachers across Europe are offered. The Future Classroom Lab is a unique and inspiring learning environment that challenges visitors to rethink the role of pedagogy, technology, and design in their classroom curricula. FCL aims at primary and secondary teachers and also ICT coordinators who are enthusiastic to enhance their teaching through new ideas, new tools, and new pedagogies. You may find resources and self-learning material on different topics, videos, webinars, publications, etc. Other areas you can find resources are digital coded and curriculum, virtual learning environments, digital leaders, the whole school development and leadership, teachers training material, and the living school labs. You can also receive resources for past courses such as trainers manuals, development courses, supporting materials. The content of the modular courses are now all complete and offered free of charge, of course, to the user, to the teacher, training organization, and other training providers.
At this slide, you can see the several resources for teachers for their professional development. Some of them can be used as a self-study material or by teacher trainers who wish to use this material as a part of their course for teachers. Now, we pass to eTwinning.
eTwinning is out there since 2005. Since 2007, it was integrated in the lifelong learning program. After 11 years, its pillars are the eTwinning platform, the Twin Space, and the eTwinning Live. eTwinning aims to encourage European schools to collaborate using ICTs, offering a range of online professional development opportunities for everybody in the European community. From experienced eTwinners to newbies, everyone has the opportunity to progress professionally with eTwinning. Through learning events, online courses, professional development workshops, and thematic conferences. Learning events are short, intensive online events on a number of themes related to pedagogical aspects. And they are led by an expert and include active work and discussion among teachers. Learning events include also asynchronous and sometimes synchronous activities, and they can in a widely spoken European language. For example, there is one now co-organized by STEM Alliance, eTwinning and Scientix, focused on schools and industry collaboration. e-twinning online courses. The e-twinning online courses are long courses aimed at addressing the needs of the e-twinning community in the area of online moderation, teaching and learning. Professional development workshops are three-day face-to-face training events covering a pedagogical topic. These events are run in a widely spoken European language and you can get a certificate of participation. The thematic conference are 3 days face-to-face awareness events. The themes are related to pedagogical aspects in general, and the main goal is to inform and create awareness about the twin.
Well, Nicolas, have you started preparation of Erasmus Plus application with your colleagues at school?
Not yet.
Oh, let's hurry up, because Erasmus Plus give opportunities for people of all ages, helping them develop and share knowledge and experience at institutes and organizations in different countries. With Erasmus Plus, training opportunities are available to staff working in education, both in teaching and non-teaching capacities. Training periods abroad can consist of job shadowing, observing periods, professional development courses, or specific competence building events.
And let us highlight that Erasmus Plus supports training both at Education Institute and at relevant organizations operating outside the section. Opportunities can take part professional development activities are available to staff working at all levels of education.
Well,
and now we can pass to Ize and on DS.
Because we have some suggestion of courses that we could apply for GA1.
Every project here is related to another. So, supporting the modernization of STEM education and training, Ize and ODS have brought to us teacher a numerous of very interesting projects and personal development opportunities. There is a unique collection of open digital education resources, innovative pedagogical practices, implementing resource-based and project-based approaches in order to design educational scenarios. The offered resources and tools are not only impose a fixed curriculum, but can support a model that can be customized based on location and culture. For example, innovative pedagogical practices such as using real-world learning, inquiry-based and project-based approaches can be very helpful in order to design educational scenarios by reproposing existing e-learning tools. A teacher can select and exploit freely available existing e-learning materials and resources that suit his or her needs in terms of planning, assessment, implementing and sharing ideas, managing and organizing classroom curricula. You can create effective project scenarios to use in the classroom as well as in multiple environments such as face-to-face, online and other technology-mediated learning. Open learning networks approach allows us teachers to access other teachers' course materials.
Well, teachers also can be trained to select and exploit existing e-learning tools and resources in terms of planning, implementing and sharing pedagogical ideas, managing their classroom and organizing the curriculum. Such a comprehensive open learning networks approach that allow teachers to access their colleagues' course materials, share their own and collaborate is expected to enable all stakeholders to examine their own practices in the light of best performing approaches. Well,
now, ODS. ODS is the umbrella project of ISE, GridNet, Quantum Spin-off, GeoThing, GoLab, and many more. There is the online community with an enormous number of communities and social networking, and the main goal is to support schools innovation and train schools leaders and leading members to promote the development of their schools in open learning communities, addressing also the resistance to change within the school. ODS promotes innovation in school by introducing new ways of producing, accessing and using educational content, familiarizing with game-based learning tools and approaches, and developing competence for fostering inclusive learning, and also by supporting teachers and students in engaging in difficult ethical conversation about, let's say, identity, beliefs, democratic values, diversity, violence, in order to establish a firm foundation for inclusive and tolerant school.
And now. Well, now, last but not least, Scientix, our Scientix. For me, Scientix was a main drain in my professional development. Under European Schoolnet, the European Network for Science Education, the Scientix, promotes and supports a wide cooperation between STEM teachers, education researchers, policymakers, and other STEM education professionals with a view to contribute to the development of national strategies for the winter adoption of innovative approaches established through research results in European educational communities for science and mathematician education. The participation of the Scientix enables access to sources of interdisciplinary action plans for STEM lessons, participation to online training workshops, seminars and e-learning communities, webinar, forum, community of practice. One of the main objectives of the Scientix portal is to support the scientific teaching community in Europe in locating high quality resources in STEM education. And what else can we note?
We must note here that the Scientix Resources Repository is one of the easiest ways of getting teachers to explore new pedagogical approaches when holding their STEM classes. The repository includes teaching materials, reports on other types of public derivatives resulting from projects, policy and research documents or other teaching and learning materials result from the European Commission activities or from the activities of other national or international bodies.
Can we go to the slide for...
Yes.
Have you ever imagined, any one of you, that you could organize event or professional development in your school? In my school, we are working 15 to 20 mathematician teachers for preparing lesson plans based curriculum of algebra to classes of high school. We have meetings every week, but we don't stop in planning and just creation of worksheets. We implement them to students while the group of other teachers observe the learning process. This activity is supported by the University of Athens and under the direction of two school councils with great experience, we discuss the results in order to assess the feedback. So, I suggest you that it's time to make motivation and start doing like something this in your school.
That's it. Thank you for your attention.
Now we have plenty of time, I think, to discuss with you and exchange your view, listen your questions. And at the last slide, can you go, Nicolas? We have all the relevant links.
Uh-huh.
And of course, we share links during our presentation. And many of you, maybe you have keep notes. Now we would like to discuss with you, listening your ideas, your questions, and of course, a lot of thanks to European Schoolnet and Scientix again for this opportunity that we have to share with you our ideas.
Thank you both for the presentation. I think there is one question on the chat that I can see. It's quite specific. I don't know if you see it. It says, are there any online tools or videos available in the Teacher Academy or the Teacher Classroom Lab website for gaining in courses or any applications such as hands-on methods, 5E or 7E methods, or inquiry-based teaching? Every lesson or domain such as math, geography, or life sciences, or biology? That's quite a specific question, actually.
Yes, I think that yes. And in links that we share with you and the links that there are in the last page of our presentation, you can find information and contact details. So I also would like to refer that to Future Classroom Lab website. There are many, many interesting training courses for KA1 application, and you can find a full catalog of these courses. Also, we share the link for courses to Marathon to Athens in July. The weather and professional development can be combined, and we think that some of you, we will meet you in July to Athens or in any events of our training course of Scientix or European Schoolnet.
May I say something on 7 inquiry-based learning? I have plenty material on that. Please take my email and I can pass everything about the 7 inquiry-based education. You can also use theatrical approach, science theater, in order to game, play in all, especially in biology or geology or even on chemistry. Okay.
Okay, we are here for you if you want to ask anything else.
It is very open.
If you want to contact with us, we here there are our emails. We will be happy to have collaboration and meeting you again in training events for our professional development in Scientix, in Athens, in European Schoolnet, in Future Classroom, in training events. All of these that we share with you are very good opportunities for join and participation.
Well, many thanks to all of you. I don't see any questions in the chat. I think it was quite comprehensive, the presentation, and you included a bunch of links, which was great. So just many thanks to everyone for participating in the webinar and for sharing the ideas and the resources. In the upcoming days, we will send up a follow-up email with the survey, and we will upload all the recording and all the materials shared on this webinar, also on the Scientix Resources Repository. So again, thanks to the two presenters today and for everybody for coming to this webinar, and see you soon.
We also thank all of you for your participation and your attention. Thank you very much.